Are you still married yet? Yeah, I'm still married. Oh, really? Are you really married? Are you happy? Y'all don't really get sick. Are you really happy? And you tell me, yes, I'm really happy. Oh, really? Satan wants you back. They became terrified. And listen, sometimes when Satan shows up, he'll terrify you. You become terrified. Because when you thought you had left, coming back in. Something you thought that you had forgotten about a long time ago showed up. Ever got a witness? Mean you no harm. Heal Israel. They felt hopeless. They felt helpless. They felt defenseless, but they saw a way out. The only way out when Satan's on your trail is to look up. Call on the name of Jesus. Have I got a witness? Don't blame the preacher. Don't blame the pastor. Have I got a witness? Israel cried out. They complained. Pharaoh, on our trail, Moses and Hebrew brought us out here in the wilderness. Pastor, here you brought us over here on 69, every day on radio. Here we are. Amen, blessed Lord. We could have been somewhere else. This is where the Lord places us. Here, people of Israel begin to complain, begin to murmur. They had short memories, and sometimes when Satan come on our trail, they have short memories. We forget that God brought us to the last event, the last attack Satan came. God shielded us. God protected us. Have I got a witness? So here comes Satan again. And what you need to do is say, yes, you came last time, and here you are again, but I know God is bigger than you. So get behind me. Get under my feet. Have I got a witness? We've got to learn to talk to Satan. Listen, we've got to learn to tell him, because we have the power. Listen. Third thing I want to tell you, that when Satan's on your trail, stay calm and confident. Don't panic. 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 Because God will fight for you. Look at verse 13 of our text. I'm almost done right here, y'all. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not, stand still, and do what? See the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. For the Egyptian whom you see now, today, you will not see them again, no more forever. What does it say? God has the power to make your enemies disappear. I said, God has the power to make your enemies disappear. He says, stand still, people. Stand still, Israel. Stand still, Mount Tabor, and see the salvation of the Lord. That your enemy you see today, you won't see again. Let me just ask you this question. Is there some enemies you've seen before you don't know what to see right now? And then this time you've been vexing your spirit, been causing you all kind of problems, got on your last nerve, almost made you lose your religion, you won't want to see anymore. Have I got a witness? God will remove your enemy. I'm going to, but see, God don't want to hear more. Have I got a witness? He says, fear not. What? Don't be afraid. No matter what the problem is, God's message to you is don't be afraid. Listen, if you lost your job, don't be afraid. If you have financial difficulties, don't be afraid. If you have family problems, don't be afraid. If there's sickness in your family, in your body, don't be afraid, because the God we serve is bigger than that. And he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. I'm going to proceed, but I want you to know, he says, the text says, be confident. Why? Because the Lord will fight your battle. He says, the one you see, the Egyptian you see right now, that you won't see them anymore. The Lord himself will fight for The last thing I want to tell you is this. Give God time to work. You know, we've got that microwave mentality. Have I got a witness that we want it right now? We can't wait until tomorrow. But I come out and tell you that God operates on his own time. Is there anybody that knows that God operates on his own time? Aren't you glad that God operates on his own time? Listen, he may not show up when you want him to show up. But I promise you, when he shows up, not only is he on his time, but he's right on time. Can I get a few witnesses to know that he will show up just in the nick of time? Just when you know Satan had you down and out, you were out three times, and if God shows up in your life, Satan can count you out, folk can count you out, but here God shows up in your life. Three Hebrew boys. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, going to the sea, they were placed in a fiery furnace. You know the story, they would not bow the old Nebuchadnezzar. They said, listen, you can put us in the den. You can put us in the fire. But as a God, we know. He may not show up when I want him to show up. He may not show up when we want him to show up. But I promise you, he will show up. They put Hebrew boys in a fiery furnace. And when they looked over in the furnace, they said, then we put three in the furnace. But there are four of them in the furnace. And it looks like the Son of Man. I come by to tell you this morning that God will in your fire. God will get in your problems. God will fight for you. God will fight your battle. Moses said to the people of Israel, just stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I come by to tell you, I'm table, and I guess, just stand still. Let God fight your battle. Fight for you.